about 75% of people who seek treatment or go through treatment for alcohol use disorder relapse within 12 months post-treatment. So that means there's a large addressable market, and there's a significant unmet medical need for moderate to severe alcohol use disorder in the US market, which we're pointing AWKN at.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Solvonis Therapeutics CEO Anthony Tennyson. Anthony, very good to speak with you this morning. You've announced an update on Awakn's pre-IND meeting with the FDA for its drug candidate, Awakn 002, and it looks positive. Tell us more.
Stephen, it's good to speak to you and to your audience again today. We're very pleased about the progress. So recently, Solvonis Therapeutics announced its intention to acquire Awakn Life Sciences. And today we've announced, and Awakn has announced, the positive progress and the positive feedback that Awakn Life Sciences, whom we're hoping to acquire, the positive feedback they received from the FDA during a pre-IND meeting that they held with the FDA in December of last year, where they were seeking guidance and support from the FDA on their regulatory strategy for one of their drug candidates titled AWKN-002, which is targeting moderate to severe alcohol use disorder in the US market. We're particularly pleased about the result of that pre-IND meeting because the FDA have been supportive of Awakn's R&D strategy, particularly important for Awakn and for Solvonis Therapeutics, is the fact that the FDA have supported Awakn's proposal to proceed straight into phase 2B without the requirement for any further clinical data. And that's really important because that provides Awakn and Solvonis with clarity on the direction for the R&D program, reduces time because it seems that the FDA is supportive that Solvonis does not require a phase 2A clinical trial. And very importantly, the FDA also supported indicated its support, I should say, for Awakn's desire to seek an expedited regulatory pathway through the 505B2 program or pathway, whereby Awakn can cross-reference the data package from an already approved drug. And that already approved drug is J&J's Spravato, which is on label in the US for the treatment of treatment-resistant depression, and is in fact forecast to become a blockbuster drug this calendar year.
Anthony, tell us more about the drug candidate and what it's targeted at.
Yeah, happy to do so. So what Awakn is doing is it's repurposing esketamine, which is one of the antimers for racemic ketamine. It's actually the more active antimer for what Awakn is seeking to treat the target indication. And it's repurposed that into an oral thin film for sublingual and buccal delivery, so below the tongue and into the cheek. Awakn has access to patents, proprietary patents around the formulation of that drug into the sublingual oral thin film. And Awakn itself has filed patents for the use of that drug product for the treatment of alcohol use disorder. And as I mentioned, Awakn is targeting the treatment of moderate to severe alcohol use disorder in the US market for AWKN-002. And what people should be aware of is the fact that, unfortunately, 29 million Americans suffer with alcohol use disorder. The current standard of care is pretty poor. About 75% of people who seek treatment or go through treatment for alcohol use disorder relapse within 12 months post-treatment. So that means there's a large addressable market, and there's a significant unmet medical need for moderate to severe alcohol use disorder in the US market, which we're pointing AWKN at.
Anthony, what are the next steps?
The next steps are the FDA has said that we need to establish they recommended that we establish a scientific bridge to J&J's Spravato. So we're going to do that as rapidly as possible. And once that scientific bridge has been established, Awakn and Solvonis are going to apply for approval, or are going to seek approval from the FDA for a phase 2B clinical trial for AWKN-002, targeting moderate to severe alcohol use disorder in the US.
Anthony, I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress with that. Thank you very much for the update today.
Stephen, thank you very much. A pleasure, as always.
It's Anthony Tennyson, the CEO of Solvonis Therapeutics.